All right, so next one is improper inventory management. This is basically a rename of a previous vulnerability in 2019. It was something like improper asset management. So what is the concept of an asset when it comes to APIs? An asset is anything that allows us to expose operations through the API. So an API version, the whole version of the API is an asset here. An endpoint can be an asset. An HTTP method can be an asset. And so the question here is, as the API evolves and it changes through the lifecycle of development, we're going to get new versions of the API. We're going to deprecate certain endpoints or HTTP methods. And so the important thing here is that when we aim to retire those previous versions or endpoints, the important thing is that we actually do it. Because a lot of the time we release a new version of the API with security improvements and patches, we forget to retire the previous one. And so if a malicious user discovers that those versions or those endpoints are still live, they can leverage, they can exploit this vulnerability to try and break access into our API. So what do you think, Frank, we can do from a design point of view to prevent this?
I think there's a few different tactics. So I think, you know, designing with extensibility in mind is a very important one. So that allows you to evolve and enhance the API without having to, let's say, introduce new major versions, deprecate older ones, or deprecate endpoints. So as much as possible, always think about extensibility here. It means you can have less variations of, let's say, live APIs out in the wild. But you then also need to be able to manage your API portfolio. So having the concept of an API portfolio, an API catalog, where you're recording the different metadata about the API so that you can make good informed decisions, and that keeps your architectural metadata also up to date. You know, we don't want these APIs to kind of fall into that zombie state. So there should also be tests there. So if you are deprecating something, make sure that you've tests as part of your CI/CD flow to fully validate that they are no longer accessible and in production.
Perhaps an idea here, a lot of these API gateway products allow you to manage this versioning and releases of the API. Perhaps an idea here is to also ensure that when we are deprecating an endpoint, is to make sure the new version of the API certainly doesn't have that endpoint. It's something they certainly could do.
Yeah, absolutely. Makes sense. Good suggestion.